गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ क्लास 11th मैथ्स लेक्चर 3rd ऑफ चैप्टर 7th परमुटेशंस एंड कॉम्बिनेशंस. सो आई हैव गिवन यू होमवर्क एक्सरसाइज 7.2. नाउ सी क्वेश्चन नंबर सेकंड ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 7.2. इज 3 फैक्टोरियल प्लस 4 फैक्टोरियल इज इक्वल टू 7 फैक्टोरियल. सो द आंसर इज नो. वी कैन चेक दिस. 3 फैक्टोरियल प्लस 4 फैक्टोरियल इज इक्वल टू, इन प्लेस ऑफ 3 फैक्टोरियल राइट डाउन 3 इंटू 2 इंटू 1 प्लस in place of this 4 factorial write down 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So this is 6 plus 24, that is 31, and 7 factorial when you will calculate is 5040. So these two are not equal clearly, so the answer will be no. Right, now we will discuss the permutation only. So in the previous lecture we have done that when permutation, when objects are not distinct, then there are two cases, either objects repeats or objects do not repeat. So when objects are distinct, that is all the given objects are different and objects do not repeat, then the permutation of n objects taken r at a time can be calculated by npr, which is equal to n factorial upon n minus r whole factorial, and r goes from, because r is greater than 0, so r grows from 1 to n, right? Now the second case is when objects can repeat. When objects are different, objects are distinct and objects can repeat, then permutation of n objects taken r at a time is n raised to the power r. So see the proof of this. So I have already told you that the number of permutations is equal to number of ways in which these r vacant places can be filled, right? Now because we have n objects, therefore for the first place we have n options, but because objects can repeat, therefore for the second place also we have n options, for the third place also we have all the n options, and so on, for the rth place also we have all the n options, right? Therefore number of ways in which r vacant places can be filled is, for first place n option, for second n option, for third n options, and so on, for the rth place also n options. Therefore it is equal to n raised to the power r, because we are multiplying n r times, right? So it will be n raised to the power r. Here also r goes from 1 to n. Now the second case is when all the objects are not distinct. Now in the previous case, when the objects were distinct, there were two cases, right? Either objects can repeat or objects cannot repeat. Now in this case, when all the objects are not distinct, there is only one case, that objects cannot repeat. So suppose we have to find the number of ways of rearranging the letters of the word root. Now the objects are not distinct because here O is repeating twice, right? So suppose if the word task is given, now in this all the objects are distinct, therefore number of permutations will be n, here is 4, and we have to arrange all the letters, so r is also 4. So the number of ways in which the word or the letters of the word task can be arranged is 4p4, that is 4 factorial upon 4 minus 4, 0 factorial. So 4 factorial upon 0 factorial is 1, that is 24. Now but in this word O is repeating, so this is the case when objects are not distinct. Now let us assume that these two O's are different and give these two O the name as O1 and O2, right? We are considering for the time being that these two O's are different. Now one arrangement of this word can be RO1 O2 T, and the other arrangement is RO2 O1 T. That is, we can change these two, right? But because O is same, we have just given them the names O1 and O2, but in the given word root, these two O are similar. Therefore, these two arrangements will give us only one result, that is ROOT, right? Because these two letters are same. Now again see, this is the one arrangement O1ROOT, and this is the another arrangement. If we consider these two O as different, then this will be another arrangement O2ROOT. But because these two O are not different, therefore this will give us the same result, that is OROT. Similarly, you will see that these two will give us the same result. These two will also give us the one result. These two will give us the one result. Similarly, this one also will give us the same result. This one will also give us the same result. These two will also give the same result, and these two will also give the same result. So you can see for each two, we are getting only one result, right? So for each two permutation, we will get only one result, because O1 and O2 gives 2 factorial, that is 2 arrangements, which corresponds to the same result. That is, if we just shift O1 and O2, then they will give us the same result. This is also the word root, and this is also the word root, because these two O are same, right? That is why total number of ways in which this word, in which objects are not distinct, can be done in 4 factorial. See, these are 4 letters which can be arranged in 4 factorial ways. But because O is repeating twice, therefore for each two arrangements, we will get only one result. Why? Because O1 and O2 can be arranged in 2 factorial ways. Because these are 2 letters, therefore we will divide this 4 factorial by 2 factorial. So 4 factorial is 24 and 2 factorial is 2. So you will get 12 arrangements. Clear? Now the number of ways of arranging the word institute will be, so these are in total 9 letters which can be arranged in 9 factorial ways if all the objects were distinct. Now, but all the objects are not distinct. I is repeating twice, therefore you will divide 9 factorial by 2 factorial into T is repeating 3 times, therefore divide this 9 factorial by 3 factorial also. That is, this gives us the result that the number of permutations of n objects, where P1 objects are of one kind, that is P1 objects are same, P2 objects are same, and similarly and so on up to PK are of the kth kind, that is PK objects are of same kind, then the number of permutation will be n factorial upon P1 factorial into P2 factorial and so on into PK factorial, right? Now see the question, to find the number of permutations of the word Allahabad. Now see, this Allahabad word contains 9 letters in which you can see A is repeating 4 times and L is repeating 2 times. That is, this is the case when the objects are not distinct. Therefore, number of arrangements will be 9 factorial upon, because A is repeating 4 times, so divided by 4 factorial, and L is repeating 2 times, so divided by 2 factorial also. So you'll get this as the answer, right? Now there are some of the results. So NP0, as you know, NPR is N factorial upon N minus R factorial. Here R is 0. So this will be N factorial upon N factorial. N factorial upon N factorial is now 1. So NP0 is 1. NP1 is equal to N factorial upon N minus 1 whole factorial. Now this N factorial can be written as N into N minus 1 factorial upon N minus 1 factorial. Cancel out this. So you will get that NP1 is N, and NPN is N factorial. Why? Because NPN is N factorial upon N minus N factorial, which is 0 factorial, and 0 factorial is 1. Therefore, you will get NPN is equal to N factorial, right? Now the question is, find n if np5 is equal to 42 into np3 and it is given that n is greater than 4. First of all, solve this. Np5 will be n factorial upon n minus 5 factorial equal to 42 into this np3 will be n factorial upon n minus 3 factorial. So cancel out this n factorial, and from this n minus 5 factorial and n minus 3 factorial, n minus 5 factorial is smaller, therefore break this n minus 3 factorial in terms of this. So n minus 3 factorial, take it this side and also break it, n minus 3 into n minus 4 into n minus 5 factorial upon n minus 5 factorial equal to 42. Now cancel out this n minus 5 factorial. So you will get n square plus 12 minus 7n, and also take this 42 this side, minus 42 equal to 0, which will give you n minus 10 into n plus 3 equal to 0. So n can be either 10 or minus 3. But as it is given that n is greater than 4, therefore n is equal to 10, right? Now next question is, find r if 5 into 4pr is equal to 6 into 5pr minus 1. So this is also very simple. 5 into, apply the formula of 4pr, which is 4 factorial upon 4 minus r factorial, equal to 6 into this 5pr minus 1 will be 5 factorial upon 5 minus r minus 1 whole factorial. Now 5 into 4 factorial upon 4 minus r factorial as it is equal to this 6 as it is. This 5 factorial can be written as, because here it is 4 factorial. So write down this 5 factorial as 5 into 4 factorial upon, this will become 6 minus r factorial. Now cancel out 5 into 4 factorial and take this 6 minus r factorial this side. Also break it down as 6 minus r, 5 minus r into 4 minus r factorial upon 4 minus r factorial equal to 6. Cancel out this 4 minus r whole factorial. So you will get 30 plus r square minus 11 r minus 6 equal to 0. So you will get r minus 8 into r minus 3 as equal to 0, which will give you either r as equal to 8 or r as equal to 3. Because in the question you can see they have given us 4pr, 5pr minus 1. So because r is always smaller than this number n, now here n is either 4 or 5, so r cannot be 8, therefore r will be 3. Clear? So we can say that r is equal to 3 because r lies from 1 to n. Now your homework is, you have to do question 1 to 8 of exercise 7.3. Okay, thank you.